Spotlight, 9 класс, страница 158, Exam Practice Section. Study skills, true, false, not stated. The order of the questions is the same as the order in which the pieces of information are presented in the text. Read the text quickly to capture the gist of it. Then read each statement, underlining the keywords. Find the part of the text containing the information referred to. Decide if the statement is true or false. If there is not enough information for you to decide, the answer is not stated. Preparing for the task 9. Read the statements and the underlined keywords. Then read the extract from a text and write true, false, or not stated for each statement. Find the words, phrases in the extract that helped you decide. People visit St. Petersburg from all over the world. There are 80 theaters in St. Petersburg. The State Hermitage is the biggest structure in St. Petersburg. St. Petersburg is a popular tourist destination with millions of tourists of all nationalities visiting every year. It is a city of culture with more than 200 museums, 200 libraries, and over 80 theaters. In addition to that, there are 45 galleries and exhibition halls, 62 cinemas, and about 80 other cultural buildings. Its crowning glory is the State Hermitage Museum, a complex of buildings that includes the Winter Palace and contains, among other treasures, the largest collection of paintings in the world. 10. Read the text. Decide which of the statements 1 to 8 are true, false, or NS, meaning that you can't give a clear answer to them, not stated. Write down the number you think is the right answer in the box. The longest rail journey. The Trans-Siberian is the big train ride. All the rest are peanuts. Eric Newby, the big red train ride. Russia is by far the largest country in the world, stretching east to west across two continents, 16 time zones, and over 10,000 kilometers. That's why it has the longest railway in the world, the Trans-Siberian Railway, which connects St. Petersburg with Vladivostok on the Sea of Japan. Over 9,500 kilometers away, over 150 years old. It is still a main connection with plans to make it an indispensable part of East-West trade, though mainly a freight train carrying goods from the East to Russia and the rest of Europe. It has long attracted the more daring traveler. For 7 days, the passengers sit in their carriages, staring out as the train crosses mighty rivers like the Volga, skirts mountain ranges like the Urals, and pulls across the seemingly endless Siberian steppes. Such a journey is not for everyone. As Siberia developed in the late 1800s, the need for such a railway was created, though the huge empty lands had enormous potential for agriculture. Roads were few, and those that did exist were often impassable during the winter months. Instead, people usually got around by river and on the ice of those same rivers during the savagely cold Siberian winters. But this was not an ideal solution. In March 1880, future Tsar Nicholas II started building the railway in Vladivostok. Soon, tracks began to be laid in the west too, the plan being to meet in the center. In 1890, a bridge was built across the Ural River, and the western half of the railway entered Asia. The bridge across the River Ob was constructed in 1898, and in the same year the first train reached Irkutsk on the shores of Lake Baikal, but it was not until 1916 that the final section was completed just north of the border with China, and St. Petersburg and Vladivostok were finally joined. The railway soon formed a successful link between Siberia and Central and European Russia, both physically and economically. It was in fact too successful. So much cheap grain started flooding the West that the farmers of Central Russia were threatened with economic ruin.